Sebastian?
Yep.
All right. Let's play.
Okay. Piano is always something I wished I had had the time to learn, so I was excited by the opportunity. You know, what other job is it a part of your job to just, you know, sit in front of a piano for 3 months and play? It was a great opportunity, so I just took advantage of it.
Actually, literally the first time I met with him about the project was in April, and I think like a day or two after that, he was in full-on piano lesson and dance rehearsal mode.
My name is Liz Cannon, and I am the piano teacher slash coach slash guru for Ryan Gosling in his role as Sebastian. When I first met Ryan, he made it very clear to me that he was not a pianist. He had played by ear a little bit, but didn't have any technique, didn't read music, but I knew that he was a very musical guy already.
He told me he barely played before he started learning for this film.
It was a very new challenge to teach somebody who had never played piano, jazz piano in particular. So jazz is its own animal, and there are very specific things that happen in jazz that maybe don't happen in other styles of music. He wanted to actually be able to play everything. The time element was not really going to make sense for him to learn to read music. There wasn't time to learn to read and to play all that stuff. So he learned everything by rote. I showed him, he thought about it, he tried it. We went over and over again. He memorized it, and he was very, very committed, as I was, to try to get it as close as possible. We worked together 2 hours a day, usually 5 days a week, sometimes 6 days a week. Sometimes he would videotape me playing it and watch it later.
It was really one of the most fulfilling, pre-production periods I've ever had.
I thought in this town it worked on a sort of one for you, one for me type system. How about two for you, one for me? How about all for you and none for me?
That's perfect, yes.
First day he was playing Jingle Bells.
One of the hardest improvisations occurred on, I think, Ryan's first or second day of shooting.
The second day of shooting was when he started playing a Christmas song and he kind of morphed into his own world of what drove him.
Told to play Christmas music, doesn't want to play it. Can't take it anymore and launches into this beautiful melody that he's written that's the love theme of our film.
We did initially think, just in case, have a hand double on set because, you know, obviously Ryan wouldn't be able to, you know, play all of these pieces because they're just, you know, there was too many and they were too hard.
Quote unquote professional musician who can serve as a, almost like a stunt double, but for music, you know, for overhead shots or back shots.
We were gonna film in long takes proving that it was in fact him playing piano.
And then saw Ryan play and realized, nope. No double in this movie. He learned every single note he needs to learn.
And the melody gets more and more complex until it sort of riffs out into a jazz improvisation. And his performance was impeccable. Second day of shooting.
It was a great day. That day was a great, great day. I was just walking on air afterwards. I think everybody was.
I just heard you play.
He learned to play the piano stunningly well.
From that day on, there was never a hand double on set. He was dismissed because Ryan, in his attention to detail, in the hours he poured into training, became this fantastic pianist.
In fact, there's not a single, not even a close-up shot of hands in the entire movie that's a piano double. Every single instance you see of any piano playing by Sebastian in the movie is Ryan.
I was jealous, man. I was watching him play. I was like, wow, this guy's really good. And he just learned this in the last few months. It's pretty amazing.
So that was really exciting. If there's a certain level of authenticity to what you're doing, that will rise above. That sort of talent, trumps everything.